Hello everybody and welcome back yet again to another React video. Today we've got a request from somebody who's a regular on my Twitch streams. If you want to go watch those, twitch.tv/catharsisdrums every Wednesday and Thursday. And he has requested this band quite a few times before, but not this specific song. So here I am to give NEMOPHILA's Revive a shot, because I've enjoyed a lot of their songs. I've enjoyed trying to play them. Some of them are insanely complex and hard to play blind and live like I do. But, I mean, that just makes me want to hear it and actually dissect even more. So I want to see what they've got today. Ooh. I was just starting to process what the... that like ethereal guitar in the background, but nope, we're here. All right. No time to think. Right, all time to rock. Oh yeah. Oh, the crunch of that guitar. Ooh. Oh, that's a unique texture. I haven't heard that in a long time. Damn, those screams. Okay, I forgot she can do that. God, her... How does that not hurt? Ooh. Hold on, I want to go back to hear that. What was that? That fill there. I can't tell if that was like a flam down, or if it was like a flam on the feet and then too solid on the toms. That was super unique. Hold on. I think it might be a blend. I'd have to see that in a live video. That sounded super cool. It didn't sound like any flam fill I've heard recently, and it definitely didn't sound just like boogadoog, just like same, like hands in unison. That's why I'm thinking it might have just been like the slightly offset foot thing. Anyway, sorry. Cool. That sounded sick. I love how they can immediately flip it to sound almost poppy. Like, you go from fucking straight metal to pop. Like this kind of like pop punk inspired thing. Right back to just straight metal. Ooh! Their drummer again. Jesus. I'm sweating. Okay, yeah, I was actually expecting a halftime, but I'm here for this, a solo. There was that insane tom work again. I really want to know what she's doing there. I'm going to have to look up a live version of this. Great double pedal. That was so much! That was so much drum fill! Okay. I think I was actually right on the flam part. I'm gonna have to think about it a little bit. I Okay, so now that the song is done, I can kind of let my brain expand a little. So, I think that I was right. I think my intuition was correct that that was a, like, a flam down, and she was, like, using her feet to go with it. But I think she was just doing it so fast, and with the tone of the drums, it just sounded a little bit more, I'm not gonna say muddy, but crunchy. Like, there was some rocks in that mud. Like, there was a little bit of grit in there. You would almost argue that it could have sounded a little bit sloppy, but given that the rest of the song had that really, like, tight grit with the guitar distortion and everything, and of course the vocals, holy shit. Like, I'm not a metal vocalist, and whenever I try, I can feel it straining my voice, and I know it shouldn't. So just hats off to people who can do that and not hurt themselves, who have, like, the training and technique down. Just all to them, like, wow. But looking at the drums and, like, how that actually worked, the fact that it was a little less clean actually made it sound better, more unique, more interesting. It made it fit with the rest of the song better. Whereas if it was just like a band-made Akane on the drums, her constant flam fills are so consistent, but they're always clean. Whereas, like, that style would not have worked in this song nearly as well. It would have, like, serviced. It would have been fine, but there's something about it being a lot tighter together that made it sound a little bit more messy and kind of like it was falling apart, but in a clean way. I have no idea what I'm talking about. All I know is that it sounded great, but I can hear what the intent was. And the fact that it sounded good, even though it honestly, by any technical mean, really shouldn't have sounded like it belonged, it did. So, I guess I'm stuck at an impasse where I have to, like, lay the drumsticks down. I don't know if that was supposed to be that way, or if it's just the way that she was playing, if that was intentional. Like, if that was a stylistic choice, then holy shit. If that was just, like, her playing that fast, that's just how it sounded, cool. But I feel like they would have fixed that before recording. So it must be intentional. Or if it started out as a mistake, and then they decided to keep it. I don't know. But what I do know is, holy shit. Man, I'm just consistently impressed by these bands, and by these composers that you guys are having me look at. Even though I know some of them, even though I've known the past couple by name and by a lot of their work, it's every time I get thrown a new experience from them, I don't know how to take it. And I'm always impressed, and I'm always surprised by something. So, wow. I guess with that, that'll be the end of this video. God, I'm really looking forward to the next one at this point. I'll see you guys all next time.